Welcome back to my channel, guys. I hope you're enjoying all of this keto vlogmas content that I'm putting out every day leading up until December 25th. So today I thought we'd just sort of take a break from the tips and recipes that I've been sharing with you and let you know a little bit about my journey and why I started keto. Because it's not just one reason. It's not just primarily weight loss. It's others too, because keto diet provides so many benefits for people. There's a lot of different reasons why people go on it, not just for weight loss too. So for my journey, it was weight loss. I had just had my second child, and with each pregnancy, I had gained like an enormous amount of weight just because I was so addicted to carbohydrates and I couldn't let them go. And so it wasn't until my husband started, this was like six or seven years ago, he had heard about this new diet. It was something that Dave Asprey, who's the man who invented bulletproof coffee, he had talked about, like a high fat, low carb diet, and had eaten all this wonderful food and still managed to lose weight. And so we started researching it a little bit more and found some more people that were involved, like Maria Emmerich and Jimmy Moore, and all of these stories of people losing weight and feeling wonderful on this diet. So we decided to give it a whirl. So from starting this diet, I lost maybe around 30, 40 pounds of that baby weight. That's great. That's like one of the main reasons why you should do it is to lose weight. Weight loss is faster for some and slower for some, and then some people end up stalling. But that's a whole different other topic. But weight loss was my primary reason why I started keto. And then once I was on it, like, I started seeing all these other benefits, and so did my husband too. It was like the benefit of having increased energy, and like, you could think a lot better too. Like, you just weren't bogged down like this constant fog and tiredness throughout the day. Like, I felt great. I woke up awake. Like, I actually felt like I could sleep shorter amounts of time, but it was better quality sleep too. Yeah, just tons of energy throughout the day. So that's kind of what kept us going at it, is that we just felt great. Like, we could rattle off stuff and at a moment's notice information, just because it could come to you a lot quicker. And my husband does like computer stuff, programming stuff, and so it's really good for him. He's on meetings all the time talking to people, so he needs to be able to be sharp and with it and be able to converse. And me, as a pharmacist, like, I need to be able to just focus on checking prescriptions, then all of a sudden switch gears and focus to helping customers and giving consults on medication, then back over to, okay, is this correct? And pulling up all this drug information and data into my head, like, at a moment's notice. And so I've noticed that being on this diet, like, it's easier for me to recall stuff and to switch back and forth and to multitask and to stay focused throughout the day too. So that was like, weight loss was number one, but honestly, like, the energy and the mental clarity, like, all of that increased with it, and that's what kept me going with it, and that's what always brings me back to it. I'm not saying that we've been 100% for these 6 years, but it's, you know, we have our moments, and then we always come back to it because there is a huge difference. It's like the main thing, a huge difference in how you feel, like your energy level is the main one. And with that, I also started noticing that when I would eat bad, and this is before I even started the keto diet, I was having like inflammation problems. Like, my joints were achy, my legs hurt, was standing on my feet all day as a pharmacist. Like, I just get all this fluid that would just retain and rush down to my legs. Like I was kind of starting to get miserable. I felt like I was getting arthritis at the age of 30. And once I switched over to the keto diet, like, all of that went away. I didn't wake up with soreness or achy joints. I didn't have like a ton of fluid retention in my legs throughout the day. Like, all of that was gone, because the keto diet is naturally an anti-inflammation diet. And so you're not retaining all that water, all that inflammation that causes all that joint pain. So that was a third reason why I kept going with it, was because I didn't feel horrible anymore. I wasn't in pain anymore. And along with that, like, I would notice when I would eat carbohydrates or even come off of it, like, I would start to have bad gut pain. Like, it was not good for me. And when I'm on the keto diet and removing all of those carbs or processed foods, like, I don't feel that. It feels great. And then also, one of the reasons why I've kept going with keto is that it's actually rekindled this love of cooking. I always really enjoyed being in the kitchen and, like, trying to find the best recipes for, like, cookies and cakes and spaghetti, like, just always trying to find those best versions out there when I was not on the keto diet. Well, this has really stimulated my passion for cooking. Like, I'm able to just really think outside the box and think about how I can make all of my favorites into keto versions. And so I love that. I love the creativity that comes along with it, with cooking. And I love cooking too. I like cooking for my family and knowing that I have whole ingredients in there, good ingredients going in there. For the most part, I sometimes use some processed keto food sometimes, but it makes me feel a lot better knowing what's going into their food. And I've really developed this passion for cooking and developing recipes and taking pictures of my food. If you were to say that I was going to do this like 6 years ago, I would probably laugh at myself at the thought of, like, you know, doing all this and cooking and making these recipes and taking pictures of my food, because I always thought that was ridiculous. I'm sure some people still think it's ridiculous, but I love it. I've actually am really starting to love food photography too. So those are the reasons why I started keto. That's kind of my keto story. I'm curious what your guys's is. Let me know down in the comments below why you started keto and what your keto story is. And make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you can get more of my keto holiday content. Have a good day, guys. You're keeping me on.